Oh, really?
I'll talk to you.
Okay. I spoke to you.
Yeah, he told me.
I spoke to you.
I told Effie to try to find
some help. Motel
Gunkin.
Effie. Yeah. We're on top of it.
Okay.
Are you kidding me? We're on top of it. Chavali. All right, boys, come. Dedicate the shiur today, you know, to the Yilui Neshava of this Yid. Apparently, he's my neighbor. I don't think I ever met him because he's Matiti Alkon 24. I think it's one of those buildings right across the gan where our kids go. 33-year-old Yid, Yishai Rivlin. Did anyone know him?
No.
You knew him? Really?
My daughter was good friends with his daughter.
Oh, wow. Then gone. 33-year-old Yid goes to Miluim, and Hashem Yirachim, very, very heavy. So I wanted to do this for his Yilui Neshama. And today is a thing that I know that everyone in the world wants to adapt to more. Our parsha of Mishpatim is packed with mitzvahs, with halachas, packed with it. It's like after a lot of stories and, you know, a lot of high moments, a lot of experience moments, all Chazal. I'll speak about, like in Ishbetu says, that you come from Igra Rama Labira Amikta. You come from Hashem talking to you on Mount Sinai last Shabbos to what happens if your ox, goes meshuga. And a lot of the tzaddikim are, you know, everyone, they're all trying to figure out why is it like this and is it like this? Why is it like this and is it like this? So we're gonna learn three words and we're gonna try to understand what these three words really are. What is this? Here you go. What are these three words? The three words you have on the top of your page is it says in the middle of the parsha, Midvar Sheker Tirchak. It's one of the halachas here. And the question is, what does it mean? What exactly is the Torah saying to us? Because it uses a language that doesn't usually use. If something's wrong, if something's asur, then what does it say? What should it have said?
Lo
teshaker. And if something's mutar, it would be like bechentas. It's almost like midvar sheker tirchak sounds like a from Chumrah that came years later, right? It's saying tirchak, harchaka. Harchaka. What is a harchaka? So we're going to see over here, and bichlal, who is the Torah talking to when it says midvar sheker tirchak in our parasha, right? I want to read you the psukim before and after that to get a little bit of perspective. Lo tate mishpat avyoncha beribo, midvar sheker tirchak venaki v'tzadik al taharog, ki lo atzdik rasha, v'shochad lo tikach, ki ha-shochad ya'aveh pikchim v'yisalev divrei tzadikim. So who do you think the Lashon, midvar sheker tirchak, is referring to? Who is the Torah talking to when it says, stay away from words of sheker? The Dayanim. Rashi says, and other Rishonim Achronim are speaking about it as well.
What is sheker?
Lie. But since we know that the Torah is applicable to each and every one of us, l'ol me'ad, it can't just be that it's only speaking to the Dayan, to the one that are judging. They for sure have to stay away from Sheker. That's already, like, can you imagine a world where the judges who are achrai on making sure that everything is calm and steady, that they what? They're allowed to be around, you know, the influences that can totally, change their minds. How do you know? What kind of world would that be? Wait a second. What kind of world is that? Oh yeah, that's right. Well, good morning. So we're going to see some pearls here. We're going to see some very interesting pearls. And I'm already saying that we're not going to cover the whole aspect of the world of Allah. What we try to do is try to understand, is this a mitzvah saseh? Is it midaraisa? Is it midarabanan? What is this mitzvah exactly? Midvar sheker tirchak. What is this thing exactly? So we're going to get back to Unkulus probably at the end. But Uncle has a very interesting way of translating stay away from lies. Mipitgama de shikra have rachik. What does that mean? Mipitgama de shikra have rachik. What's a pitgam? Like a saying. Or a H-Y-M-N.
Hymn.
From a hymn of sheker, have rachik. Have means actively, forcefully move yourself away from. Be in a state of rachik. We're going to get to it later on. Now, just to show you that the array, it's the Rabbi Elazar Mitz, the smag, the Sefer Mitz was Godel, the smag, Sefer Mitz was Katan, these are all, and the Rashbats, these are all Svarim that would, Rishonim that would, Achronim that would basically define whether something falls into the category of the 613 mitzvahs or not. We have a lot of different minyanim like this, right? They say it's a mitzvah to say Shabbat Torah. Now, Reb Sadia Gaon, the Rambam, the Ramban, and the Sefer HaChinuch don't count this as a mitzvah to say Shabbat Torah. Now, that alone is very, very interesting. How could it be that we have such an inyan that's so running through a very fine line over here?
Do they count it as a mitzvah to say
Shabbat Torah?
No.
A very good question. When, over here, right, it's not that they say it's a losa. So we're not trying to figure out if it's an asay, a losa. I say, is it bichlal daraisa? Or is it derabanan? What is it exactly, this mitzvah? What's the inyan here? And when we learn it like this, we'll understand, when we learn all the fluffy stuff, not fluffy stuff, you know what I mean? When we learn the other stuff later on, but it's on the basis of understanding how Chazal interpreted it to be, it'll help us understand the depth of this mitzvah. Yeah, Yeshua.
I think sometimes one of the things is sometimes when one of the big four here, Rabban,
right, the big four.
So when they don't include something in, often it's because it's such a big concept, it's not a little mitzvah.
Okay, so you're already jumping, but that's very, here it's very clear.
Right.
Mitvar sheker tirchak. How could you put that into the context of one mitzvah? Anshe kodesh tiuli, it says in the parasha. It says already lotane beracha et shaker, it says in the Aseres HaDibros. Meaning, it could be that this inyan is, you're right, it's so big, and it's already shown up in many different places, to say on its own, it's one thing, what would you do with all the other stuff? That may be a way of them looking. Do you understand what he said?
Mm-hmm.
That's a very important inyan. Nechon meod.
the foundation.
Correct. If it's part of the foundation, mentioning on its own may work, but what does it do to all the other times that it actually really shows up in a different fashion on its own? Came up on a certain level, right. So that's, and especially, yeah, the big four, Reb Sadia Gaon, the Rambam, the Ramban, and Sefer HaChinuch. So, where do we go to from here first? Where would we jump to? We would go to the Chofetz Chaim. How does he understand this? Because if there's been the Rebbe of this Pasuk, it has been the Chofetz Chaim, the Kayan from Radin, Rabbi Yisrael Meir, a Kayan of Radin. Has to be, we have to go to him. So he says like this, this is in the intro to Hilchos Lashon Hara, to his whole world of Shmirat HaLashon. וחוזה שדיברנו עד עתה, הוא אפילו אם הוא מספר דבר אמס על חברו. Everything we have mentioned by now, just make it clear what Chofetz Chaim is saying. Lashon Hara does not mean sheker. Lashon Hara can very, very often mean emes. In fact, most of the time, it is emes. What would we call Lashon Hara? What would we call sheker when someone says sheker about somebody?
Not something that didn't happen.
Not how do we refer to that? Bechelos or motzi shemra or
slander?
Yeah. So he says, don't get confused here. Midvar sheker tirchak. The Chofetz Chaim is saying, what does that mean? Because it could be that it also means midvar emet tirchak, right? Certain emet, certain elements of emet, you must distance yourself from.
In the context of
Lashon. Correct. Correct, but it's very, he's making a distinction here, and it's a very important one as well. Let's finish what he's saying. Aval im betoch halashon hara o arechilut shelo nitarev tarovet shel sheker b'mitzvato over gam ken al mitzvas aseh shekasu b'torah midvar sheker tirchak. So he's saying over here, you're in the middle of hearing a bunch of lashon hara, and there's a lot of emes that the person is saying bad stuff about homeboy. But what happens while he's saying the stuff that's true? You sprinkle in some sheker, some exaggerations. Chofetz Chaim says, ah! Guess what happens to you? Not only are you over on the mitzvah on the aver of Lashon Hara, you're also over on the mitzvah's asay of midvar sheker tirchak. So what does the Chofetz Chaim hold? Mitzvah's asay shebat deraisa. Absolutely. It's amazing though how he says it. He's like, listen, if it's not enough for you, that hearing truth about someone, which is not nice, is bad. Chances are, in that conversation of truth about someone, you'll hear some schmutz about someone too. That's not true. So whatever way you look at it, Chofetz Chaim is saying, run away. But definitely, we brought this piece of Chofetz Chaim to show us, he holds it a mitzvah sasech deraisa, midvar sheker tirchak. Meaning the concept of hearing lies about somebody. Not hearing truth that's bad, hearing lies, midvar sheker. Now,
to know how do we know what is a lie?
So what would the whole Chazal say? Well, since you never know. Harchaka.
You're over two.
Yeah.
He's saying,
yeah.
Even if it's true, you're still over on the person.
It doesn't matter if it's true or not, exactly.
But exactly. Something nice about the person.
So that's interesting what you're saying. Halacha speaks about this. Wait a second, you're starting saying something nice about the person. Do you know what in Chabad they really makpid on in most places? Just don't talk about people. Sometimes you start saying something nice about someone, and you end up like something really bad comes out about that person, or the way the person understood it. Don't even start.
Is he talking about the person who said Lashon Hara, or the person who hears it, or both? Or does that?
No, it does. There's a lot of ramifications. It doesn't matter. You're asking specifically over here.
Yeah,
I think it's about
it
the person that's hearing.
As it
seems.
He says the person is saying it.
I heard it that it was both, actually. Both the teller and the hearer.
There's a ring, both of them.
You're fair. I think it's a typo.
Oh.
And I think that the word is over gamken.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very good. That's my mistake with it. Yeah, very good. If it was over him, then it'd be much easier to answer the question. But yeah, okay. So the Gemara, so this, I saw this Gemara and I thought it was very important for us to understand what we're standing before, this inyan of sheker, that I think we take very, very lightly. It falls under the premise of we're just human, right? We're not angels, like we say about mistakes all the time, right? But if you apply that to sheker, to you being into lies, I think you're really messing up the picture. And we'll see. You understand what I'm saying? We always say, we're just humans, this thing, it's not such a big deal, we made a mistake. Said it, that's one category. But then to apply that statement, we're just humans, we're not angels, to saying, whatever, we're into shkarim, that won't work.
And we're not angels, only work after the fact.
Not before the fact. Even after the fact over here. Even after the fact, to look back and not be too hard on ourselves that we're in lie, that lie is part of our life, that's what I'm referring to. So look at the Gemara. Look what the Gemara in Sota says. Sota Membez. Look at this. Amar Rabbi Yemiya bar Abba. Arba kitot ein mekablot pnei shechina. It's very interesting. There are four. It's interesting. Like we know the word kita is class. Let's just call it that for now. Four sections for people that they don't receive the face of the shechina. Not in the latid lavo. Not like only Mashiach times. Now. Kat leitzim, what's that? Lazy clowns, or what's that?
Jokers.
Yeah, it's hard to say exactly what it is.
Like foolhardy people, like people who are just not serious about anything ever.
Yeah.
I would
put that in here. Yeah, definitely. Kat chanifim, leitchanef. You know what that means? The butter uppers, you know those cover? No?
It's usually falling into like the exaggeration category, right?
Quite often, yeah.
You kind of overdo it. We shouldn't judge them though, they may really have their intention and be flattered.
But the Torah says don't.
That's
so they
go to their head.
Kat shakarim, those that are caught up in the world of lies. The kat mesatrei lashon hara, and obviously the ones that fall into the category of our chevra, what defines us? We're lashon hara talkers. Now, it goes into, and the Gemara goes into how they prove from the pasuk each one why this group of people won't mekabel pnei shechina. When it comes to shkarim, it says dover shkarim lo yikon leneged einai. Those that speak shkarim, they cannot be in front of me. They can't be with me. Now. That's a very heavy pasuk because it's from David HaMelech. Because what is it saying over here? The scariest thing is when someone can lie and look right into your eyes. Like usually when you lie, you kind of like, like this or something. But if someone can lie to you and look into your eyes when they lie to you, it's probably because they are so convinced that what they're saying is not a lie, or they've been able to justify it to the greatest degree.
Or they're just ready to lie.
Right, yeah, meaning they're completely they're desensitized to it. So we see over here that the concept of sheker is something that the Ribbono Shel Olam cannot be. There's no room for it. Not because you're a bad boy, you lied. It's because this relationship here. That's not, there's nothing going on over here. The world of lies, when a person's in that place, there's nothing else that can happen in a relationship. It's not like, I have this problem with lying, but other than that, I'm really good with Hashem. It doesn't, I have this thing with my wife. I lie to her, but our Shalom bias is so amazing. we're laughing, but
There probably aren't many other things where lo yachol neged einai. Like that's
right.
The whole point of the Hashem is everywhere. Right. This is like to actually take a stance here.
Yeah.
No, because somebody lies to you, you can't trust them. There's no trust, there's no relationship.
Yeah, but Hashem knows the truth, so
No, but Hashem says, be honest with me. Right. Fine, I know you have faults, but be honest with me. But if you're going to lie, then there's no relationship. There's no basis for trust or anything. None, nothing, not even talking.
Is Hashem saying he's not there, or that he can't?
No, no, they can't
accept his.
They can't have eye to eye.
Yeah,
they
can't communicate.
They
can't communicate.
Right.
Nachon.
Yeah.
Nachon.
We have to stop lying to ourselves too.
Oh, good luck on that one, my friend. Okay.
And
figure out
lying,
how to crack that code.
Yeah, isn't lying to your spouse the shalom bias an okay thing to do? That's a really beautiful dress you have, darling.
You're bringing up a sugi I didn't want to get into, which is that. No. It's very good you're saying it. It's fine. Because what everyone here knows, we have a concept called Mishan Mipnei HaShalom. That of Shalom, you do sometimes have to. Huh? I haven't figured out that word yet. I don't know Mishanin. I don't know. Bending, I've heard bending that sounds much more than outright lies than, you know. No, no, honey, it's bending. We're bending the rules here. I don't want to go into it so much because what's the problem with that? Where do we have the best example of someone that bent the truth? Everyone we're named after.
Rachel?
Yaakov Avinu. La Rachel with her Abba, and we know that she gets punished afterwards for what she said about hiding the trophim, Nachon. But really the best example that, and obviously biblical critics have a field trip with this one, is Jacob the liar, right? Oh, I didn't even say those words.
Well, Abraham lied too, about his wife. And he's about to lie in the Torah.
Nachon. Nachon. It's true. We don't give it that much emphasis.
There's
always something. That's what we're saying.
Right.
Yeah.
It's super complicated, right? Yaakov goes through a lot of what he goes through, being tricked himself with clothes and everything else. It's nonsense.
None of us think it is. No. So I'm not going to pretend to introduce this concept to you. I want to leave it to the Gadol of Dessler, of Eliyahu Dessler. The Michtav Meliyahu, it's your what?
I was thinking about learning from the Sefer today, this morning.
Michtav Meliyahu. So the Rav Dessler says like this. I'm sorry we have to run through this because the woman shears soon, but there's so much in this piece. We'll try to do as much as we can. Mahu emet u mahu sheker. What is emes? What sheker? And we're doing this to understand what the Torah means when it says midval sheker tilchak. That's the point of what we're trying to see over here. But obviously, he's going to bring us to Yaakov and Esav over here. Right? We're going back over here. Ma'u emet u'ma'u sheker. B'tchilat chinuchenu hevanu she'emet hu k'shemesaprim uvdot k'mo she'iru v'sheker k'shemeshanim mizeh. So when we were young, what was chinuch? What did the world tell us? When I tell facts that took place, that's emes. When I tell false facts, when I report false facts, it's sheker. Ach zeh urak b'ofanim pshutim. Like Eli is saying, okay, that's when it's simple matters. Over the ma'aseh, yesh harbe ofanim shebehem ein hadavar ken. There's many instances where it doesn't work like this. Israeli, take things. Lefamim asur lomar dvarim kmo shehem. Sometimes you can't say things like they are. Kmo. Lesaper ma sheyesh bo pgam lechaver o bli toelet ve'echrach. Right? What example does he give over here? When it's not a thing that you should say just because it's emes? Hey, you know, you really, right, you're off, bye. Right, with no follow-up, nothing, right? By the way, you know that, it's amazing, my father once had a bar mitzvah student who had severe Tourette's. Did I tell you this story? Years ago, I think I told the chaver many years ago. And Tourette, a severe Tourette's is when they blurt out whatever is going on, there's no filter. Now, it's not lies either. It's all emes. But my father had a mamashal experience. I was a little kid living in Los Angeles. And this bar mitzvah kid was, my father, such a tzaddik, because, you know, the guy, I don't even want to tell you what he was calling my father and all these names and everything, but they keep on going. Meaning, there's this, like, I feel like you're a non-Tourette's, you have the same like non-Tourette syndrome of like you know what I mean? It doesn't really.
You have healthy Tourette's.
Right, more or less. Which we said the other day is a huge bracha. Right? Didn't we say that the other day? Like,
yeah.
We'll figure out how we. Let's try to make shalom with. I mean, like what we're trying to say is like. We want to make shalom between the place that really does like that nekuda pnimis that always wants to say emes. They don't want to. It's very choking for the soul of someone that wants to be real to know that we don't yet live in a world, or maybe never aren't supposed to live in a world where everything that we're feeling comes out.
This is so perfect to follow up on what we're doing with the food.
Yeah. Okay. ולפעמים צריך דווקא לשנות, but sometimes you דווקא have to bend. Okay, whatever that word means here. And when is this take place? וזה כשהאמת לא תועיל אלא תזיק. What do you think of my new album? I get asked 25 times a week, right? You think I'm going to tell them every time what I feel? What I really feel? Right? So in that situation, is that sheker? So according to Rav Dessler, he's going to show us that's not really what the Torah is calling sheker. And that's why it gets confusing. That's why we have to really be done like this. וזה כשהאמת לא תועיל אלא תזיק. This is when truth is damaging. And not, like Rabbi Akiva talks about tochecha, that the reason why probably nobody can give tochecha is because you can only give rebuke if you believe Remuna Shlema that the person that can receive it, and can do something with it. Aside from that, it becomes your own bag that you're just trying to unleash, you're trying to unload. So look what he says here. Ki az ma shenira ke'emet hu sheker, shemolid tocaot shel ra, u'ma shenira ke'sheker, mevi letachlit shel emet. He says, what a weird world we're in. That which seems like truth ends up causing a world of sheker, because it births out tocaot shel ra, bad results. And on the other hand, that which seems like your sheker, wow, what a beautiful production you put together. Mevi letachlit shel emet. A person wants to try harder to do it even better next time. That's what he says. Oh yeah. This is a chiddush. This piece. I saw this piece. I was really blown away. Nimtza she'emet hu ma she'mevi letov uleratzon habore. So it seems, according to Rav Dessler, emes. The definition of emes is something that brings for good. It brings goodness, and it brings for the ratzon of Hashem. Huh? It's a very tricky game. We're not done yet. We're in the middle. Hold on. We're like, whoa. Wait a second, boys. V'sheker hu ma shenoten atzlacha la'asakav shel sara sheker asitra achra. Sheker means you've given employment to, he calls it here, like, basically almost every government official that we have right now in this country, right? Mi she'ikar shifato l'ra'u l'sheker, right? Even though mix in here a bunch of facts, mikom makom l'sheker yechashev lo. Even with your emes that you've sprinkled on over here, you used facts, you used emes to just serve your greater picture, which is sheker, which is manipulation. This is so heavy. Ki kol pirtei ma'asim מצטרפים ככלים לתכליתו העיקרי. All the details gather together to form a vessel for a person's real purpose. ואם מטרתו היא שקר, if the person's real purpose is manipulation, then all the pieces of truth he used along the way lose the status of truth. They become שקר. He says, הכל שקר. That's what he says. יש לומר שגילונו חזל כאן משפט שמיים. So we see over here, חזל have revealed to us an amazing thing. What's emes and what's sheker? And now we're going back to Yaakov and Esav. Yaakov עשה אומנם באורמה. Yeah, Yaakov, he did what he did, אורמה. Trick, deceitfully. אבל עשה בעל כורחו. He was forced to do this. בוכה ואנוס על פי הדיבור. He sensed the רצון of Hashem. And even it was. What do we know about Yaakov Avinu? Ish tam yoshev o'alim. It's a peaceful, chill tent dweller who's connected to the midah of emes with the all of him. Baal Yechassidus says, you really want to do a fixing in this world? You got to go against your nature completely. That was Yaakov's avoda in this world. To go, we say in the morning, we just said titan emes le'Yaakov. It's such a weird thing. Because Yaakov Avinu's way of him's tikkun of revealing emes in the world was having to, so to speak, doing all these shinuim, but to serve the purpose of emet in the world.
That's been so hard for him to do that.
To terrifying. There's a whole Torah of Shlomo has on Rivka coming to him and saying, "You got to put on the clothes now." And you know why he was so terrified? He says, not only because it was like so against his nature, but also because he didn't feel like he was worthy of the bracha. Twofold over there. But yeah, petrifyingly, so against his nature, his character. We don't read the psukim like that. He says over here, forced, anus. Anus means literally raped. Al pi adibur, because it was the ratzon of Hashem that he should get these brachas. Lo kiven li ritzonot atzmo klal. When he was acting the way he acted, it was nothing about him. Rak lehotzi lapoal hatachlit hanirtzeh mehashem, but to bring out into actuality the tachlis that is wanted from God, the sheker l'shem emet, hu ha'emet. This is like, and you know what's so weird? This is like, you know who Rav Dessler was? You know what the Sefer is? Michtav Me'eliyahu? This is the most sharpest, one of the most sharpest Sifrei Musar, Book of Ethics that we have. And look how he's, look what he's saying over here.
Can you translate that? If it's Ratzon Hashem. So in the case of Yaakov, what Rav Dessler is saying is that his nature was not to save his life, he was forced into it, and he ended up being able to follow through it because it was Ratzon Hashem. These words came out of his mouth, but forcefully. He didn't want it. It's like almost Hashem animated his mouth and made the words come out.
But he still did, he had part of the acceptance of the gig.
It's a very hard thing to, like you're saying.
Very hard. Let's continue.
But for us who maybe can't determine what Ratzon Hashem is, suffice it to say that that is a beautiful dress, and that's what we're talking about here.
Well, we also, like, we know the Ratzon Hashem is Shalom Bayit.
Right, so like we can take this Adam Chavero and say like, yes, this is what allows us to make those small lies because we're not hurting somebody else. So that, maybe that's as far as I would think.
Let's see. We're not finished yet. Esav Meyased Shitat HaTzvuim HaMitkayemet Ad Hayom. Esav is the founder of, how do you say Tzavua? Yeah, the world of hypocrites. What are we going to say? Josh, you got a hechsher from Ellie that's a big
I
wouldn't take that lightly. Or maybe he's bending.
He purposely waited a couple of seconds.
And he bent. He's like, yeah, that'll work, sure. Really, he's thinking like, that is not how you say this. Mishan in Ripnei Shlomo. I see he's going on. No, I'm kidding. But I'm not. Esav Meyased Shitat HaTzvuim HaMitkayemet Ad Hayom. He's the founder of the hypocrite party, Ad Hayom. Esav HaMevakesh Le'aser Teben U'Melach. He's asking his halachic shaylas about tithing salt to his father when really he's murdering and raping out when he's in the fields. Hu Shechidesh HaMinhag She'efshar La'asot Kol Averot She'ba'olam U'Liyot Im Ze Ish Nichbad. It was his chiddush. It's amazing how Esav is like ruling the world today. What's his chiddush? That there's a minhag. What's the minhag? Just seem like you're asking right questions, or that you blurt out some like facts here and there.
Care about what matters.
Sound like it,
yeah.
And do what you need to do, and you'll gain respect in this world. That's Esav's chiddush in the world. Ish kazehu kulo sheker. Now, ish kazehu kulo sheker. He's all a lie. But he's asking, he sounds very firm, and he's asking very good questions. Now, he didn't really explain to us, what did Rav Dessler say about Midvar Sheker Tirchak in this case? It seems like he's saying, Midvar Sheker Tirchak, distance yourself from anything that serves the greater Sheker. But not literally any word of Sheker, because then we can't stand with Yaakov Avinu.
He starts by saying, not by the definition of truth and life when you're a child.
Nachon? So now, let's run. Now we go to the Heilige Baal Shem Tov on the Parsha. And the Baal Shem Tov used to say like this. I'm just going to read you the, unless you really, really want to hear me speak Yiddish right now, I'm going to read you the Hebrew. My children, Banai, Ein atem tzrichim yoter l'rak lishmor l'atzvachem me'od min ha'sheker. U'bazet tiyu l'anashim v'dolim. Meaning, after everything the Baal Shem Tov told us, after all the stories and Torahs and everything, Baal Shem Tov says, my children, All you got to do is guard yourselves from sheker, and through this you'll be big people. Anashim gedolim. We have three Torahs here from Reb Simcha Bonu Abshescham on the same light, the same concept as well. Midvay sheker teichak. Next page. Pam achas la'achar Rosh Hashanah, kshenifta Rebbe Rebunim Zatzal, et ha'olam anshei shloma inu leveitam leshalom. One time after, like, must have been after Yantiv or something, when he said goodbye to everybody that came to be with him, Reb Simcha Bonu Abshescham. Now this is important because who's one of his top Talmidim? Whose Yahrzeit was this week? And? The Kotzker. You'll understand a lot of cuts by these pieces right now. He went, Amar lekol echad ve'echad, the Heilige Pshischa went up to each one and said, Ani shu'am imcha davar echad, shetavtiach li, shetetzayet li. I'm asking you for one thing, promise you'll listen to me. And then what he said, so everyone said yes. But vadai, yeshiv lo kol echad sheyetzayet lo, everyone said, of course, I will listen to you. Ve'az amar lo, shemavakesh bimeno, shelo yomar sheker im emet. Meaning the bottom line, Rebbonim says, you want to know what Chassidus is? The real thing, the real deal, just don't say lies. Only say truth. Ulechol echad amar adrim alalo. Now, do you know that when we read a statement like this, part of us says, what's the chiddush in what he said? When the yeled inside of us is saying, thank you, yes, that's right. That's really what it's all about, right? Part of us is just like, well, whatever, like, you know, ma chidush, is it a mitzvah or not? Is it a mitzvah or not? It's everything. Look how he continues. The next one. Midvay sheker tirchak. Shamati v'shem ha-Rabbi HaKadosh, Reb Simcha Bonu Abshescha Zatzal. Now, this is interesting. I heard the name Reb Simcha Bonu Abshescha, shelo matzinu bechol ha-Torah kula, shenasa erchaka. The language of distancing is not found by anything in the Torah. There's no other mitzvah where there's harchakas. Rak chachamim hizir lasot harchaka. The whole inyan of harchaka, meaning the extra, even the language, not even anything extra, but the language of distancing yourself from something, we know those are all gzeiros derabanan. Siag lachom, right? There's a siag. How do you say siag in English? It's a prevent. Huh? A fence, a geder, like it's a fence. But it's not the real inyan, it's just a fence from it. Reb Simcha Bonu says, where does it say this language by any other thing in the Torah? Just about sheker. Aval b'sheker, tzivta ha-Torah be'atzma la'asot ha-rechaka. Mize nishma she'dvar sheker hu aveir ha-gdola. So, he's answering a question we had in the beginning. Is this a mitzvah saseh or not, according to the big four? It's not. Why? Because maybe they're saying the Torah already mentioned this language of sheker, this, that you can't sheker and the shaker in other places. But the Torah knew how much the Yetzer Hara comes and convinces you all the time and plays mind tricks with you that it's okay. So in the Torah itself, there's a harchaka. There's like a derabanan in the Torah. That's why it's not a mitzvah. That's why, according to the big four, it's not a mitzvah to say d'oraisa. Do you hear what he said? I think that's how we're learning it out. Do you understand? Yeah. There's a mitzvah to say in the Torah, lo taneh berachah et shaker, anshei kodesh tuni. There's a lot of other places where it speaks about shkanim, right? But the lashon midvar sheker tirchak. What did we say according to the Rambam, the Ramban, and Reb Sadia Gaon and Sefer HaChinuch? That it's not a mitzvah to say. Why? For whatever the reasons are. Reb Simcha Bonu and Reb Shisma is saying, will we ever hear the language of harchaka, distancing yourself from something in the Torah? No, that's a language of derabanan, right? Mm-hmm. Why? Because when something's really, really, when it's very much
dangerous,
we add harchakas. So Reb Simcha Bonu and Reb Shisma is saying, it must be such a gevaldically huge aveira that even in the Torah there's the language of a harchaka.
They already gave
me the Darabana. Yeah, that's
the point. The Darabana is
the... Yeah. That's the point.
Gave me both.
Yeah, it's like a Darabana to Darabana.
Right. Yeah. It's the only one.
Yeah.
Because this language is not found anywhere else in the Torah. All her chakas, all those other extra distancing, is only found in other mitzvahs. It's not found in it's the only one. That's what Reb Simcha Bonu Abshescha is saying. You want to really know the depth of this inyan? Midvay sheker tirchak? Focus on the word tirchak. To understand it. That's what he says. Now, I wanted, this next piece is also so gevav, we don't have time for it, because I really, just want you to open, to take this next page. It kills me. Please, if you can, please, please, please look at this last piece of Reb Simcha ben Obshesha too. But when we were on the men's trip this year in the Ukraine, I don't remember right now, actually, if it was the woman's first woman's trip, the second woman's trip. I think it was the men's trip. I ran into the bookstore that's right by the Tzion in Uman. You know, that was one that was like when right across
the street. Second women's trip.
Yeah.
Second women's trip.
Right, but the men's trip is when I did this, when I walked into the men's, because I couldn't
overlap.
At night I was falling on my face in the snow. I couldn't make it into the store. But the next day I had cleats, mm-hmm. So I was able to walk into the store, and I saw this sefer there, and I was like, "Well, I need a new sefer." I'm like, "I know I'm in Ukraine, everything, but I need to grab a sefer. I need something to hold on to." So I opened up this sefer called Eitzos Yesharos, and it's a collection of Rabbi Natan's sayings based on different topics. And the first one is Emet Ve'emunah. Now I tried giving the beginning over, this piece over on the bus, but unfortunately there's a lot going on the bus, and it wasn't heard that much, and it really broke my heart. And I knew that I had to daven over this in order to like have the opportunity to learn it again. Because it's that real. This piece is that real. Look what Reb Nassim says. Ikar ha-gesher la'avor alav b'zeh ha'olam hu emet. Like Rabbi Nachman says, the whole world is just a narrow bridge. Ve'ikar lo lefachet klal, leitpachet klal. So what is the bridge? What do you stand on to get over the narrowness of the world? Reb Nassim says, the gesher in this world is called emes. Ki Adam tzarich la'avor b'zeh ha'olam al gesher tzar. Because man has to walk over, he has to cross over a narrow bridge in this world. Ve'ikar shelo yitpachet klal. Dekar is don't make yourself scared. Now, so I'm thinking now, what does not making yourself over frightened have to do with connecting yourself to the midah of emet and not sheker?
That you don't manipulate. Because you're the feet, what are you going to think? What's this? I got to try to manipulate you to make sure that you're worse still good.
Or it's good. Lies, you have to then maintain the lies.
Lots of lies. And it's like the
drama. This is a shaky foundation.
Mamash. Ve'lizkot lezeh, so how does one merit la'avor al gesher atzar shel zeh ha'olam? How do you get through this narrow bridge in this world? Hu al yidei emet. It's just by truth. Kmo she'omrim ha'olam she'im emet yicholim la'avor et kol ha'olam ki ikar hu emet she'al zeh omed kol ha'olam umlo'o. The whole world is standing, is founded, it's existing on the concept of God's word, which is emet. Mechol ha-bilbulim v'ha-miniyot sheyesh la'adam avodas Hashem, all the confusions and those things that prevent man from really serving Hashem properly, she'ikar hu-miniyas ha-moach, what really prevents us from really serving Hashem properly is the mind games. Ikar ha-etzah la'avor ale'em hu-emet. Just attach yourself to the midah of emet, which helps man get through anything in this world. Bifchinas shlach orcha va'amitcha, like the Melech says, Hashem, send me your light, send me your emet, send me your truth. Heima yanchuni. That's what will lehanchot, conduct, guide me. Send me your light and your truth. That'll guide me in this world. Kmo shekatuv ahalech ba'amitecha. I will walk in your emet. Now, here I got the shivers a million times over, because the one nigun we know from the piyasetzner is these words, ahalech ba'amitecha. That the only way to get through the narrowness in this world is asking Hashem to hold on to the midah of emet no matter what. No matter what. That's the narrow bridge. And that's the only thing that can get us through all the narrow bridges in this world. I have to stop. I'm so sorry, guys. Today is really painful for me that we're stopping here. But Baruch Hashem, whatever it's for Ratzon Hashem, we have enough here on the table that we know what our tefillah should be on the Shabbos. plenty. Yeah. 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 Yeah.